हमारे वक्त की धड़कन, हमारा चिंतन, हमारी भावनाएं, हमारे विचार, कभी कोमल बातचीत तो कभी इंटरेक्शन तेज तर्रार। तय करें मिलकर व्हाट इज रॉन्ग व्हाट इज राइट। आईटीवी पर अशोक व्यास के साथ इनसाइट टुनाइट। नमस्कार, मैं अशोक व्यास, कार्यक्रम इनसाइट टुनाइट विद अशोक व्यास में आपका स्वागत करते हुए आज मुझे विशेष प्रसन्नता है इस बात की कि तीन पीढ़ियां हमारे पास एक साथ आज के कार्यक्रम में है और हम सब सेलिब्रेट करने वाले हैं एक ऐसा इवेंट जो बहुत कम लोगों के जीवन में आता है। एंड इफ यू आर अ टीनेजर एंड बाय द वे यू आर सिटिंग विद योर मॉम और योर डैड और योर ग्रैंडपा और योर ग्रैंडमा, दिस इज द टाइम फॉर यू टू स्नीक आउट। Just kidding. Because my guest today, Soham Daga, when they will hear about him, that he recently got the opportunity of shaking hands with President Barack Obama because he is the finalist for Intel Science. What that involves, we'll ask him. And he's also someone who received gold medal. That is Congressional Award Gold Medal, which is bestowed upon for exceptional volunteering service. There is so much about Soham that if I start talking about the student from Stuyvesant High School who is captain of the policy debate team at school, and there are many other areas which deserves mention, but very briefly I'll say he has taken many AP courses, and his grades definitely has been wonderful. So first of all, I don't start with Soham, but I want to welcome Soham. Namaste Soham.
Namaste.
बहुत बहुत बधाई है।
थैंक यू, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है आपके लिए। थैंक यू फॉर दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी, इट्स रियली नाइस टू मीट यू एंड थैंक आईटीवी एज वेल।
And I thank you. So Soham has been written about in, of course, Times of India, Economic Times, Wall Street Journal. He's been interviewed at various places, and today is our opportunity. And this is a family sort of environment for him. So we thought of involving his family also with us. So let me welcome Grandpa of Soham, T.R. Daga ji. Swagat hai aapka.
Swagat, dhanyawad aapko.
You have been successful financial professional and you are a social worker as well. Or Manoj Daga ji, you studied in America, then you worked for some time with a bank, and then you have your own business which is related to BPO. But let us begin with that moment when you come face to face with President Barack Obama. Soham, how was it? It was something the way you expected it, or it was different than that?
I didn't really have any expectation. I was just, you know, very excited to meet him in the first place. वहाँ पे क्या हुआ था कि पहले कमरा में गए थे और फिर खड़े थे वहाँ पे 20-25 मिनट के लिए, एक स्टेज पे खड़े थे, और फिर बाद में प्रेसिडेंट ओबामा आए थे खुद अपने आप लेने, और फिर वो स्पीच बोला उन्होंने, कैसे उन्होंने अपना थोड़े बायोग्राफीज पढ़े थे और हम लोग का जो साइंस और मैथमेटिकल में जो रिसर्च किया था वैसे उनको पूरा देश में बढ़ाना है, और हम लोग ऐसे लीडर्स है वो मूवमेंट के, एंड वी हैव डन वेरी वेल इन दैट सेंस। और फिर उसके बाद हम लोग सब इंडिविजुअली मिले उससे, और जो इंटरेस्टिंग बात थी कि जैसे वो टीवी में देखते हैं, जैसे टीवी में समथिंग, एकदम वैसे ही थे एकदम सामने भी, तो वो थोड़ा मुझे चौंकान हुआ, उससे थोड़ा अलग हुआ, एकदम वैसा ही था। तो 2-3 मिनट के लिए मैं बस ऐसे चौंक गया, मगर मिलना बहुत अच्छा था। उससे हाथ मिलाया, उसने पूछा मैं कहाँ से हूँ, मेरा नाम क्या है, मेरा, उसने बोला बायोग्राफी पढ़ा, उसको अच्छा लगा, मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई मिलने उससे। बस ज़्यादा 2-3 मिनट बात किया उस पाया उससे, और बस बहुत बहुत अच्छा मोमेंट था, और पिक्चर सब लिए, अच्छा मोमेंट था।
सो कमिंग बैक टू द सेम रेफरेंस, सो ही इंडिविजुअली टॉक टू ऑल द फाइनलिस्ट?
या ही स्पेंट अबाउट टू टू थ्री मिनट्स विद ईच वन ऑफ अस, आस्किंग वेयर वी आर फ्रॉम, आवर नेम, एंड यू नो टेलिंग अस ही इज वेरी प्राउड ऑफ अस, एंड वी होप ही गोज वेरी फार इन द फ्यूचर, एंड यू नो hope we can do great things for the country as well.
So he asked you, did you read his book, or you mentioned it?
I didn't read his book, unfortunately. I plan to do so in the future, but what he read is a small paragraph about each of us before meeting us in the first place. So he knows something about us at least.
So did he ask you something about the project which brought you in front of him?
No, he did not have time to ask us about the project itself, but he had read about our projects. He had been given that literature itself. We didn't have, because he had to leave right after meeting us. We saw him going with Michelle Obama onto the helicopter, and he was departing off to some political event. So, but it was just a very great opportunity to meet him and, you know, have a small interaction with him in the first place.
So he didn't have time to ask you about that project, but I have time to ask you about that project. And I know that it has something to do with the Google trend and mortgage. And at your age, and even after that, many of us don't know what mortgage is, what is mortgage delinquency, and what is the risk, how risk can be mitigated by those who are providing loans, etc. So you talked about all this in your project. So first question is it a science project or an economics project?
See, that's a really interesting question. And I think the answer to that question is it's both. It's what I like to think of it as an econometrics project. It's a project that is heavily invested in statistics and mathematics, trying to solve an economic and financial issue in the first place, and which is why, you know, it was a tough project to take on, because it wasn't purely science or purely math. It was a combination of all that. However, it did go through the science competition because of its strong roots in the mathematical field and in its application in the economics field itself. So, yeah.
So I'll try and learn a little bit more about this project a little later. But I tell you, if you look at all the statistics and the charts and the way his presentation is, it is very difficult for a common man to understand what he is conveying. But of course, that is why he is one of the finalists for, because it's science, and science is not so simple for everyone. But what is simple is love is the key to all locks. And what has brought love for economics in Soham's life, let us go and trace the route with the help of T.R. Dagaji. So, Dagaji, उसके अंदर इकोनॉमिक्स के और फाइनेंशियल एस्पेक्ट्स में इतना इंटरेस्ट आया, इसके पीछे आपके साथ इंटरेक्शन का कोई लेना देना है?
एक्चुअली आई एम इन फाइनेंस एंड दिस सिंस माय करियर ऑफ 1967. फॉर 40 इयर्स आई वाज सीईओ एंड एमडी ऑफ मेनी कंपनीज, एंड मनोज आई पुट हिम द सेम ट्रैक ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट. ही इज अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट, चार्टर्ड सेक्रेटरी. देन ही वांटेड टू फर्दर फॉर स्टडीज, ही वांटेड टू कम टू कार्नेगी मेलन. Then he did MBA, and Citibank, the whole area he's handling. And Manoj, he, in childhood, he was listening to me and most of his father that what we are doing. He picked up from there. So this is a chain of family.
So I definitely see some roots coming from you, and let us catch that moment when you came to know that he's the finalist, mm-hmm. and he's invited to White House. What was the feeling?
The whole family will delighted, and even all my relatives, because what I do in my life in for education, because my younger daughter she's also a MBA, my young she's in teaching profession, my eldest daughter she's in teaching profession. So whole family in this education only, and everybody feel delighted. Even my old in India level, even my institution which I am NGO of Virayatan, and my friends, and they are so good. So that's why I am now taking to India, and we are having a great meeting there. And Motilalji Oswal, you know, the Virayatan, this president of JANA has will chief guest, and they are, so everybody is happy. Is a real achievement of at this age.
Actually, we as ITV family are also very happy that at this age his vision is remarkable in terms of his focus being on his studies. I'll ask him how many AP courses he's taken at Stuyvesant since high school. But let me ask Manoj ji, it's not easy to guide teenagers. And what do you think helps you in helping him stay focused?
Well, I've been lucky to have Soham as a child, I think.
Clap for you, man. So
it's a matter of being proud, right? I mean, as you say, you can take a horse to the water, you cannot make him drink. So Soham has been, he has worked hard, he's very disciplined. I guess my contribution is very limited. I think the contribution is of the community, around us, which has obviously my wife played a very important role. My parents played a very important role. My father has been a social worker, right? So those values have been very helpful. Our community has played a very important role, right? I mean, the Jain community plus the community in the New York City area, his school community. I think when he went to Intel, right, I think meeting President Obama was obviously very exciting, but I think the other exciting aspects was Soham got a chance to meet several Nobel laureates in Washington, D.C. So they met him, and he has been included as a part of a club of Nobel laureates. So I think it's the environment, it's the broader community which has guided him. And most importantly, I think it's the values that he has, which we have been able to instill in him, which is best of both the Indian and the Western values, values around hard work, respect for elders, nonviolence, integrity. I think those are the values which we have tried to imbibe in him, which he has imbibed. And for that, I would give credit to mostly to Soham, but also right to our community, both my family, Indian community, New York community. I think that they have played a very important role.
So we always hear this famous line, it takes a village to raise a child. And I think the whole New York, from the point of view of Manojji, is acting like a village. And I think we have heard the Vasudeva Kutumbakam, so whole world is like a village. We all are a big family, but going to the family of Stuyvesant's high school, with respect to your project, what would you say was the role of your teachers? Because how you interact, how you learn, they help you in shaping your vision. Share with us that process while you were thinking, and there must have been some interesting exchange of ideas.
So I would say more than just the teacher itself, it was the students I was surrounded by in Stuyvesant High School. The thing in Stuyvesant, you meet so many bright and talented students who are, and Stuyvesant itself is a math and science high school, so there is a huge emphasis on these two subject areas. And so while I was at Stuyvesant, I met so many students, you know, who were so engaged in these activities, and they would spend so many hours doing these activities that, you know, I myself became very engaged in these activities. And in high school, I decided to pursue math and science to the fullest degree possible. So while the process started, I just started taking a lot of math and science classes and courses as well. And what I found was that one of my favorite courses was statistics and calculus. Those were my two favorite mathematical courses that I had taken, and I performed very well in those courses as well. So it was like a niche for me in that school itself. And so when I got engaged in that, what our school does is it has an Intel program itself, which is basically a research class the school provides. And so I was involved in the social science research class. And so my teacher in that, Ellen Schweitzer, was very helpful in the whole process. She basically helped me out identifying my project, how to go about conducting my research. She helped me out with that. You know, she helped me identify, what are the specific things I must keep in mind. And once I'd completed a large part of my research, trying to identify the impacts it would have in the economic field, because she's an economics teacher as well. So she played an integral role in my project. Other than that, a lot of my other teachers helped me out with the concepts. My statistics teacher, you know, I often consulted him on, you know, what's the best procedure to use, how can I better benefit from that. So that was huge as well. So just the research atmosphere in Stuyvesant, because I had so many friends who would just go up late at night just doing research itself, and, you know, surrounded by them, it motivated me to do research as well, you know. So that atmosphere was very important to me to do the research that I did, and, you know, I'm glad I did. I learned so much from the project, and I had a meaningful impact on society as well. It's very important to me as well.
So talking about meaningful impact, let us hear from 17-year-old Soham. If you are planning to buy a home and you don't know a little bit additional information about mortgage, just to understand. So let us see how you would make a common man understand how to go about with this process of going to a bank, mortgage. You are familiar with all these.
Right. So my project dealt with when people are unable to pay back their mortgage loans. But essentially what happens is that when you're trying to buy a house, it's very rare that a person will have all the money right away to buy the house. So they would have to take a loan. So you go to the bank, and then you basically be like, this is the value of my house, and I want to take a loan for X amount. So let's say I want to take a loan for $250,000, right? So in order to take the loan, there's a long process that you have to go through, and it mainly involves the banks verifying whether or not you can take the loan or not, and that really involves checking your credit score, checking your, you know, financial status, your current assets that you own, looking at all of that things. And once they do all of that, you can get a loan. And the loan really depends. It can be your rate can be a fixed rate loan, or it could be an adjusted rate loan, which basically means your interest rate will change over time, or your interest rate will stay the same. Your loan can be a 30-year loan, 50-year loan. So the time of the loan can change as well. And so basically, those are the different tenets or facets of a loan that exist. And then you eventually get that loan, and then you have to make monthly payments towards the loan, which involves the interest rate as well as the principal of the loan as well.
Very nice, man. So, now let me try and understand where you got this idea of applying Google Trends to this project. And for someone who is not familiar with Google Trend?
Right. So Google Trends is like everyone is familiar with Google. And what you do in whenever I have a problem or a question, the first thing I will do is I look it up on Google, right? So what if, for example, if I'm trying to buy a new car, I'm going to look up car in Google. So Google Trends basically tells you how many times that particular word or particular term was searched over a period of time. So how many times did people search up the word car over a period of 10 years. And that's what Google Trends is. And so how I got the idea was that there's a lot of good literature that exists right now. And, you know, I often read news. And there's literature that exists about how Google Trends data was being used by scientists to predict flu outbreaks. What they found was that there were certain people searching the symptoms of flus in certain regions, and often those regions were the ones that were most infected with the flu. And so what I thought was that if Google Trends is so effective in predicting flu vaccines, which is basically, you know, and it was shown to be great, very effective, the same thing could be applied to mortgage delinquencies. Because what I find is that mortgage delinquencies, basically, when people can't pay back their mortgage loan, right? And so that's a very personal thing, you know. It's like if you have a life crisis or if you have too many sudden costs, then you can't pay back. So it is a consumer-based problem, not really a supplier-based problem, right? And so consumers, when they face these problems, they will go to Google and try to find the solution. And so I basically connected those two dots together, and I thought that if we try to use this data, we can really gain insight into what the consumer is going through regarding their mortgage loan, which can help banks then make policies accordingly and predict these mortgage delinquencies in advance.
You know, you explained it so well, and before we go towards the first break, I just want a small clarification also just to sort of give a more idea about the way your project is relevant and useful, because the data would be so huge. And
right.
If a bank is operating, let's say, in New York, the
right.
Google Trend, even if it is a Google Trend of people searching for this
right.
term in New York, and it would be very difficult to see the correlationship between that trend and any financial institution that is loaning from a particular location, or I mean, how do you see? Do you see?
Yeah. So the impact is actually quite great right now, and then this is I've actually had discussions with people at Citibank, which is where I work, on how this can actually be useful. And what we found is that Google Trends can tell a specific hot zone at the zip code level, which areas consumers are most likely going to face problems, and you know, because those areas will have socioeconomic conditions that will create mortgage delinquencies to take place, right? And so what can be done as a result of this is that financial education programs will be created in those specific areas. You can start telling those consumers that if you have any financial problems, come to us and we'll help you out with them. It's more of like a preventive action, because what often happens now is that after you become delinquent on the loan, it's very hard for the bank to do anything for you. So the idea is, how do we find a tool to tell banks what areas are most likely going to have this problem? And so basically Google Trends tells you those specific areas now, and those correlations that you were saying would be very hard to find were found in this project, which is why this project was such a revolutionary project in the first place. And so once you identify those areas, now we can start taking preventive measures to prevent these delinquencies from taking place, so the bank can save a lot of money and the consumer can keep his house and the economy can continue to function as well.
So if you manage to keep your house because of one new way of understanding the problem which is brought in front of us by Soham Daga, then there would be a little bit of extra thanks moving towards him. So I extend that thanks, because you are thinking about larger good and applying your mind, your energy, your focus, your dedication. So with dedication, we'll come back to you and we'll talk more to this gentleman, who, as I mentioned, was recently shaking hands with President Barack Obama, and a student of Stuyvesant High School, his project, which brought him such laurels, becoming Intel Science Talent Search finalist. The project is using Google Trends to enhance predictive models of mortgage delinquency to mitigate risk in the loan lending process. Quite a tough project, but he's simplifying it for us, sitting in front of his father and his grandfather. So stay with us, and if you have anything that you want to ask him, now is the time after this break. You can also call us. So stay with us. We'll be right back after this break. वेलकम बैक, यू वॉचिंग इनसाइड टू नेटवर्क शो व्यास, और आज हमारे अतिथि हैं 17 वर्ष के सोहम डागा जी. सोहम वॉज रिसेंटली सिटिंग और रादर स्टैंडिंग विद प्रेसिडेंट बराक ओबामा बिकॉज ही इज इंटेल साइंस टैलेंट सर्च फाइनलिस्ट, एंड एज आई वॉज मैंशनिंग हिज प्रोजेक्ट वॉज यूजिंग गूगल ट्रेंड्स ऑफ टू एनहांस प्रिडिक्टिव मॉडल्स ऑफ मॉर्गेज डेलिक्वेंसी to mitigate risk in the loan lending process. The way I say it, I try to make it a little humorous thing, but of course it's a very serious affair. And when you are a student, it is very difficult for you to consistently maintain your focus until unless you have your mother telling you to go towards the right direction. So Soham, tell me, many times whenever mom asks their, especially teenage sons, to do something, I won't tell you what kind of reaction you can sort of have in the Google trend. But how is it for you in terms of?
I think a great part of my success was due to my parents, both my mom and my dad. There were times that, you know, I would become very lazy, or there were times that, you know, I would, you know, I just want to sit down, and my parents would come and they'd be like, no, go do your work. And, you know, they were extremely integral. And, you know, my dad was being very humble before him, and both my mom and him had an extremely important role in what I was able to do. You know, they were my, like, motivators, my encouragers. You know, in times when I was down, they would make me feel good. And when I was up, you know, they would keep me humble as well. And so times that were tough, you know, they helped me go through it. They told me any problem I had, they would tell me a solution to it. And, you know, and I'm really indebted to them for their past 4 years of effort. It's been tough. It's been very stressful for both me and for them. You know, I've given them a lot of stress as well. Sometimes they would tell me something and I would get irritated.
You know, when you sit in my chair, then you are very curious to know what way you have given them stress.
What way have I given them stress? Well, a couple of ways, you know, like when you're like day-to-day interactions, you know, sometimes they'll tell me to do something and I will have, you know, some other thing planned, and, you know, sometimes I'll do that and then they'll be like, did you do that? I'm like, oh no, and they'll be like, why? And then, you know, college admissions was a very stressful process, you know, that they helped me edit my essays as well in that process as well, and, you know, that was just a stressful thing overall. You know, I'm applying to this college and the results are coming, and it was a very stressful environment. And so in that regard, it was very, very stressful as well. But we made it together. I think this accomplishment of mine is really our accomplishment as a family altogether, and think that's really not overstating it at all. And, you know, I'm really grateful to both of them, and I hope to continue to work with them in the future as I continue on.
You talk like you are receiving an Oscar award, then of course you will receive more awards down the line. But as you were mentioning, I was thinking your father being so busy in his business, so sometimes the kind of attention which he would like to have for you, probably didn't have enough time. So Manoj-ji, how was it? Because your business is very demanding. You are operating in many countries at the same time. So tell us parenting and entrepreneur's demands.
Balance. I think my wife, Pragya Daga, who is not here, she played a very important role. And in the development of our children, mothers play a very important role. They do not get as much visibility as fathers do. But I think Pragya played a very important role. I just want to like to mention a few names. Pragya played a very important role. Pragya is highly educated, and she chose not to work, but instead be a homemaker and take care of Soham and my daughter Sama. So I think a lot of the credit should go to the sacrifices and the commitments that she made. In addition to my father, my mother Shanti Devi Daga's contributions, her well wishes, our religious leaders, Upadhyaya Shri Amar Muni Ji Maharaj and Acharya Shri Channa Ji, their blessings have always guided us and motivated us. And in addition, right, I think my two sisters, Manisha Daga and Vaishali Daga, though they live in India, they live in Mumbai, you know, it's their love and their wishes and their care. We remember that while his college application was going on and we realized it was a very stressful process, my sisters used to call us like middle of the night, hey, what's happening? Are you on your essays or not? Right? And I feel that they were more concerned than I was, right? So I really do feel, right, when I look at the contribution of my wife Pragya or my father, my mother Shanti Devi Daga.
So allow me to interrupt you. Yeah. And sometimes when we get to them in that mode of thanking, then it flows and flows and flows, which is a good thing. Yeah. But I'll just bring it back to T.R. Daga ji, and let's just compare the world that was when you were a teenager and now that you see Soham as a teenager. What is the basic difference in approach of teenagers in your view?
This is quite different because I was educated in the city of Bikaner. I graduated from there. Although I was very good in my class, I was first class first of Rajasthan University in the graduation. But at that time, my father used to tell me in class 8, you become CA, because I was not knowing what CA and what A is. And I came to Calcutta and joined my CA and LLB, I did it. And so that's the whole thing it changed today, this, you know, the revolution, this communication, even cities like Bikaner, telephone was not there in that city those time when I used to study. Airplane, we used to see in the sky only, airplane is going. So there's a huge difference between generation gap is huge. But my father, he was matriculate, but he had a vision that I'll make my son as a chartered accountant. And fortunately, he was in middle class, but he could do it. I'm the first chartered accountant of the whole Bikaner city. I'm the first. Yeah. There was no 1962 batch, my number is 8,000, and today we have 2.5 lakh chartered accountants in India. So it was proud for my Bikaner city, for my college. Then I came to Calcutta, I did my CA and LLB, and came to the this business sector.
So I bring it back. The world has definitely changed. It's very difficult for you to imagine that there is no phone at home. Now every pocket has to have a phone, or maybe you will have two phones. Many people carry three phones also. So phone is not just a home thing, it is an individual thing now. And internet is a walking encyclopedia in your pocket. But before we talk about how teenagers and internet relationship is working out in Sohan's opinion, let me compliment you for another honor that was a Congressional Award Gold Medal. And this recognition is reserved for those who have been instrumental with their outstanding voluntary contribution to the society. Congresswoman Grace Meng said for Soham, she also tweeted a selfie with him and said, Soham is an exceptional young man who walked tirelessly to help others and achieve very challenging goals. So tell me again, Capitol Hill, Washington, D.C., here Soham Daga, 17-year-old, walking out of school, going there to receive this gold medal. How was the feeling at that moment?
It was another extraordinary moment. The way it worked was that on June 18th, we came there and there was a dinner and we met all the other congressional gold medalists and the other families that were there as well. And at the dinner, there were a lot of congressmen, there were senators and people in the House of Representatives, there were a lot of business leaders. Nick Cannon, who's the host of a television show, was there as well. And there were people from Johns Hopkins and, not Johns Hopkins, Johnson & Johnson, the pharmaceutical company. And such great people from meeting all of them was a great honor. And the next day was the award ceremony. And, you know, it was an extraordinary ceremony. We were in the same room as Nixon got impeached in. And so that was it was a great environment. And, you know, meeting all the other students who had done great service as well, you know, again, it allowed me to be part of another community that really will influence me in the future as well. I'm still in touch with a couple of them who I met over there. And, you know, I met Congresswoman Grace Meng, great thanks to her. She was instrumental. You know, she gave me earlier awards as well. And, you know, we're still in touch, and she's done a great amount as well. And, you know, I hopefully meeting all these people is just a great pleasure. And, you know, I've never been able to meet them without this award, so I'm really grateful for that.
And was your family also witnessing the ceremony?
So my grandfather, my grandmother, and my father had come along with me at that ceremony. My mother, unfortunately, could not come because my sister had to stay and go to school as well. So another one of those sacrifices she has to make.
So now we talk about internet. We talk about social media, of course, Twitter, Facebook. All these things are becoming so much part and parcel of everyone's lives, and especially the amount of time that many teenagers spend with internet, either on their cell phone or their iPads or laptop, whatever, it must be running into many hours. And many of this association with internet is not productive.
Yes.
So you have to save yourself from distractions which are available there. How do you manage to stay focused?
It's actually really interesting you mention that, because recently, actually, internet obsession was recently added to a mental disorder dictionary now. It is the actual thing that exists. And I think the way I save myself from these distractions, such as Facebook and Twitter, as you were discussing, is really, you know, having certain goals and focus in mind. And I mean, having the parents in the living room is also a great, you know, focus there, because if I'm not working, I know it'll not end up well for me either. So, you know, my family, again, gives me great focus. And at the same time, you know, there are certain things I want to achieve. And I think I use social media productively as well, because I think it's important to stay connected to everyone. And, you know, earlier ages, you would have to go to their house to talk to them. And now you can talk to them quickly. And, you know, when you're working on group projects together, assignments together, social media becomes a great tool to utilize as well. So it's not really getting away from social media, but it's using social media effectively, I would say. And at the same time, not getting carried away. You know, being like, if I have a certain task to get done by a certain period of time, I will do that task, because it's not like my friends will not be there the next second, right? And, you know, once I finish that task, I can go talk to them afterwards. It's really self-discipline, again, family support, and at the same time, using social media and this internet to your own advantage now, because there are a lot of negatives to it, but I think it's also important to emphasize the positives that exist with it as well, and using those positives to its full optimum value.
I'm glad you talk about the positive, because positive of internet and partly of social media is somewhere in the realm of your father's business also. What would you say, how internet has opened up opportunities for entrepreneurs?
I think internet has opened huge opportunities for entrepreneurs in the last 10 to 15 years, and it continues to open more and more opportunities. The world is becoming increasingly digital. And that has transformed industries. We are talking about digital homes. And it has happened across the globe. I was recently, just give you an example, I was recently staying at a hotel in India called ITC Grand Maratha. And in the hotel room, there was an iPad. And through that iPad, the entire room could be controlled. The lights could be controlled, the doors could be opened, the bathroom door could be shut, the orders could be placed at the restaurant downstairs, your massage appointment could be fixed, your TV channel could be taken care of. So I think life is going to get fundamentally transformed, will continue to get fundamentally transformed because of digitization. And I believe the kind of innovation that is going to take place in the next 5 to 10 years will significantly revolutionize the world, significantly more than what has happened so far. I think much more changes are going to happen, which will significantly transform lives and industries as we move forward.
As we move forward, increasingly we are realizing that our kids know much more than us. Increasingly we are realizing that the pace at which they can pick up things from computers is way ahead of us. Now, keeping that in mind, if I request T.R. Dagaji to respond in terms of your relationship with technology and the second or the third generation, how that makes you feel? Because earlier we were living with the premises that बड़े हैं उनको सब पता है. तो उस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से क्या लगता है?
नहीं, सब चीजें, थिंग्स हैव चेंज्ड अ लॉट एंड दैट कॉन्सेप्ट डजंट होल्ड गुड टुडे. नाउ एज यू राइटली सेड, द चिल्ड्रन नोज मोर देन द एल्डर्स. आई सेइंग द चाइल्ड इज द फादर ऑफ द मैन. तो आवर टाइम्स दिस टेक्नोलॉजी वाज नॉट देयर. एज अ टेल देयर वाज नो टेलीफोन, नो थिंग्स ऑफ, इवन कंप्यूटर हैज अ ग्रेट रोल. आई कुड हैव सम पार्ट ऑफ इट. इवन आई एम लिमिटेड टू see the email and all, still not, they are not updated to the so many gadgets today. Even my granddaughter, 6 years old, seen much more gadgets than me. Always, in my time, the toys used to be different, wooden toys or plastic toys. Today, the toy is iPad. Whole day she's busy with iPad. She sleeps with the iPad. So this is a tremendous change which we can't, we couldn't think of.
तो जो हम सोच नहीं सकते हैं वो हो जाता है, तो कैसे हम उसको अपनाएं? इसके लिए भी एक विशेष प्रकार की समझदारी की आवश्यकता होती है, और वो डागा जी में है, क्योंकि उन्होंने कितनी सहजता से कह दिया है कि वो 6 साल की है, उसको मुझसे ज़्यादा पता है, और इस बात को लेकर इन्हें कोई परेशानी नहीं है, और हमें भी इस बात को लेकर कोई परेशानी है नहीं. परेशानी ये होती है कि बात करते करते जब रुकना पड़े तो वो संयम हमारे अंदर होना चाहिए, और वो सोहम के अंदर भी है. और उससे सीखते हुए मैं अब बढ़ना चाहता हूँ आपकी अनुमति से इस छोटे से ब्रेक की तरफ. सो वी विल बी राइट बैक आफ्टर दिस ब्रेक. स्टे विद अस. वेलकम बैक. यू वॉचिंग इनसाइड टुनाइट विद द शो क्यूज, एंड माय चीफ गेस्ट टुडे इज सोहम डागा, मेंबर ऑफ नेशनल ऑनर सोसाइटी, इंटेल साइंस टैलेंट सर्च फाइनलिस्ट, एंड ही आल्सो वाज इन कैलिफोर्निया फॉर International Science and Engineering Fair, where he was at first place for American Statistical Association, and in third place in Behavior and Social Sciences. So Soham, tell us, what was it?
So this was another science competition. Basically, the way this worked is that you first have preliminary rounds in your own city or region, and then you go to the international stage. And so there were people from around the world. You had people from Egypt, people from India, about 15 kids from India, people from Egypt, Russia, Ukraine, Africa, there were a lot of countries there as well. So it was a international experience in the sense there were kids from throughout the world competing in these science competitions. So I think there were about 1,900 kids that came from around the world. And the way it works, it was a week-long event. And what we did there was that we basically presented our projects to the public over there. And so, you know, and then there were also specialized groups that came. There were a lot of businesses that came. I met a venture capitalist there, you know, that was interested in my project. He gave me his contact information there. So it was a great social place, and you met a lot of cool people there. And so it was another science competition in that regard. Another one of those great communities, I had great opportunity to met a lot of great students there. I have a friend in Romania now, I have a friend in Egypt now that I can call, and you know, exactly, never been able to do that without going to this competition. So just one of those great opportunities I got in high school that I really enjoyed and, you know, will cherish in the future as well.
So I want to know a little bit more about what you did for which American Statistical Association gave you this first place.
Right, so what happened at the competition was that they looked at all the projects that were heavily invested in statistics, right? And then they came and even individually interviewed us about our project, and they basically wanted to test how much of a statistical knowledge we had. And, you know, we talked about, so as a result, we had to talk about the statistical methods we use, and, you know, the questions about, you know, whether this method was effective or not, the question is about the techniques, the question is about, you know, the math behind it. And they really wanted us to know that whether or not we knew what we were talking about. And so basically, based on these interviews, they selected the top students in statistics who they felt, and that I was awarded first. So best statistics project, I guess, could be a way of explaining that award from the American Statistical Association. And so as a result of that award, now I get, you know, I've become part of the statistical community. They have conventions that I can go to frequently now, which is a great, great honor, especially since I have a great passion for statistics in the first place.
What statistics is, many people earlier used to jokingly say that if you want to camouflage something, you come up with statistics and it doesn't say much and it hides more. So for you, what is statistics?
For me, statistics is a tool for any field at all. You know, I feel like if you're a biologist or a chemist, at the end of the day, even if you make a discovery or even if you make a certain result, to test whether or not the result is significant or not, you need statistics. And these, in the modern day, you know, finding relationships between things, that's the important thing. You know, able to connect a dot A with dot B, and that's what statistics is for me. It's a tool to connect these dots together and to figure out whether or not these relationships actually exist. And, you know, I feel like it's applicable in so many fields. I was talking to a friend of mine who's doing a biology project, and, you know, he said his biology experiment was done in a month or two, and the rest of the time, for a large period of time, he was just doing statistics and trying to analyze his data. So it's a data analysis tool, and especially in the day, a new field that's emerging is big data analysis. We were discussing earlier about how internet and social media has become such a huge thing, and a result of it, also data has become a huge thing. And, you know, and so statistics has become more and more used in our everyday lives, because how do we analyze the data? How do we use this new form of data to make decisions? So statistics is the tool for making effective decisions and using this big data to make better and more informed decisions in the future as well.
Data world is very important everywhere, and there are data processing, and there are many new business models which are evolving around how you manage data. And there are big companies, big servers, millions of dollars. But many people, like probably T.R. Dagaji or people my age, some of us feel a kind of dry thing about data. And it seems to be a very cumbersome task to understand how to deal with data. But the way Soham talks about data, looks like you find it very interesting. And taking this word interest, if I move towards the behavioral and social science, for which also you got recognition and you were at third place, what was it that you contributed there?
Right, so that was the category I was under. I was under the behavioral and social science category. And basically, economics and econometrics is a social science. And so the recognition there was mainly for the fact that my project had an impact upon the human population as well. You know, there are banks have started to look into these Google Trends now and started to develop policies based on this social media analytics now. And so it's revolutionizing the way the decisions are being done in the social science field, especially in the banking industry. And, you know, coming up with this new methodology is really revolutionizing this process. And so I was basically acknowledged for that, and that process that I developed and demonstrated how, you know, as time is going by, we should start, you know, using more of this data that is being available to us, because it's not being fully optimized at the moment. You know, this data has come out very newly. Only 2 or 3 years of this data has really started to compile, and only recently have companies started really to look at it. And in the future, I see this becoming a much bigger field in the future, and much more companies forming around the idea of social media analytics.
So data is important, and people who know how to work with data and simplify it, make it meaningful for us, are going to be very much in demand. And talking about demand and supply, always this question is relevant for anyone who is in the business or entrepreneurial orbit. So going back to Manojji, demand and supply, this plays an important role, but also a kind of social commitment that also plays its role in choosing our course of action. In your case, when you switched from banking to the new business, what was your vision?
My vision was that I think Soham continues to inspire me. I felt that I was at a stage of my life where I had done jobs, where I'd worked at Citibank, and I wanted Soham to dream bigger than the way I had done. I was a product of my circumstances. He's a product of his own circumstances. And as he was doing it, I wanted to take more risks. And I wanted him to feel not like everybody feels that, hey, listen, a good education is not about just getting a good job. A good education is about taking risks, taking chances, and making a difference to your own life, and more importantly, to the life of the community around you. I think so that inspired me to make the move. And as others who may be listening on this show, I would like to emphasize on what Soham said. Big data is going to be another field which I would like youngsters to keep an eye on, which is going to be very, very exciting, which is going to make a huge difference. So as Soham goes to study financial engineering at Princeton University, I would like youngsters to focus on this area, because I think there is going to be a lot of exciting things that's going on.
So now, first exciting thing right now for me is to learn a little bit more about financial engineering, because we have seen these two words in different brackets. Financial engineering, what is it, Soham?
So financial engineering is similar to what I did for my Intel competition. It is basically a way of merging statistics, computer science, and economics into one. And the way I like to think of it is that you develop a very strong foundation in statistics and computer science, and you develop the skill sets and learn how to use those tools to solve problems in the financial and economics field. So similar to what I had done, I was really invested in and became good at statistics and, you know, learning those statistical softwares and then applying that knowledge to the financial field and trying to solve a problem there. So that really is what financial engineering deals with. A lot of optimization and trading and all that deals with financial engineering as well. So that's really what that field is really all about. So that's why it's an engineering major, because you're really studying statistics and computer science, but now you're using the specific tools to solve problems in the financial marketplace and trying to understand how we can develop the financial marketplace better and make banks more money.
So Soham, we talked about this honors, members of National Honors Society, then Intel Science Talent Search finalists, International Science and Engineering Fair, and all these things. And along with it, you were also taking many AP courses, AP Physics, Mechanics, Electricity, and Magnetism. What I know a little bit about all these APs, even in Humanities and others also, you had AP Microeconomics. I'm not naming all of them, but AP US Government and Politics. What I know is if you are taking AP course, then you are under a lot of pressure and there are additional demands. So when you have so much pressure, where is the time to relax and what is your way of relaxing?
My way of relaxing, I don't know. I think you can always find time in the day to relax and, you know, take care. So what happens is that I come back from school around 5 p.m. and, you know, I do a lot of my book. What I find is that around nighttime, you know, I spend time with my family. I often watch TV shows, you know, movies. I really enjoy watching movies and TV shows. That, you know, it's a way.
Your favorite movie?
My favorite. I really like the Lego movie that just came out. It's one of my favorite movies. And I feel like it's actually been shown scientifically that, you know, watching these shows is a way of escaping from all the pressures around you, and then you just come right back. So, you know, it's a great outlet for me. Spending time with my friends, after a busy day or after a long time, you know, celebrating achievements with them or celebrating a end of this graduation party, you know, with them, just a great experience overall. So, you know, spending time with friends, TV, family, really spending time with people, I would say, is my way of relaxing. You know, it's a way of just escaping from everything happening and just experiencing something different, and it just refreshes you and you get right back into what you have to do.
So I think there is an important distinction. Talking to people is relaxing. It's a great gift that you have. I also want to talk to you about this aspect. You learned to develop game applications using Java from Google employees and outside trainers.
Right.
Are you very much interested in gaming or no?
Not really. I'm actually quite bad at gaming. What happens is that I go to my friend's house sometimes, and at night, you know, we have sleepovers and we play video games basically on it. And, you know, I'm actually not that good at it. I don't often win those games. But, you know, it's. But I'm not really interested into gaming itself. But I do enjoy developing applications. That idea, it really fascinates me, because, you know, whenever you see such great graphics on it, I often wonder how is this possible, you know, and learning about that and that animation is something that really excites me and something that I do want to pursue in college more, maybe minor in computer science as well, so I can, you know, get a better understanding of this, because I feel like, as we were discussing earlier, as social media becomes more and more important, internet becomes more and more important, it's very important to have a knowledge of computer science and have a knowledge of programming to be able to function at a highly optimal level, and so that's another field that I really want to pursue in the future as well.
So now, so many areas to grow. Very little time we have with us. So I want to talk a little bit about his volunteer commitments, which were instrumental in organizing medical relief camps in India. I want Dagaji, T.R. Dagaji, to tell me, was he also involved at ground level in these medical relief camps, or it was just his fundraising part?
More he was physically here, so fundraising part, you know, even he was in the school, he raised fund in the, when he was 6th, 7th school, he raised fund for us. Once he came to India, I took him there also, because I am associated one of the institution called Virayatan for last 35 years, and where we do a lot of this human services, this running hospital, school, and a lot of free camps. And so we talk over there, and after my retirement for last 12 years, I am totally devoted to this. So he helps mainly fundraising. When he comes, I join, I take them to the institution, he sees there, he talks there. So that way he has developed the interest. And my son Manoj, from, because childhood we used to go there, even that was our club since last 40 years. I used to take my children there, and they've grown with the institution.
Wonderful. They're, so what you learn where you are exposed to helps you in shaping your ideas. And Manoji, we are almost at that point where we'll be saying goodbye very soon. But talking about relationship of father and son, and you are in the middle of, you are with your father as well as with your son. They say that once they are 16, 17, or there was another saying, jab paon ke joote ki size similar hone lage, and then he's like a friend. So do you see him as a friend now? Or
I do. And in fact, I believe that the way I approach Soham so far and the way I'm going to approach Soham going forward is going to be different. Soham was significant. I did try to influence Soham with my knowledge, with my views, though we had a community around us. Going forward, I think Soham's development is not going to come from me. I think Soham's development is going to come from others.
Well, let me disagree with you on that, and I'll ask Soham also to disagree. So now, Soham, what is your vision for future in 30 seconds, if you are to say, as a great debater, this is what I want, this is parallel to that famous speech, I have a dream, what dream you have?
I would say I want to become an entrepreneur in the future. I want to start my own company after Princeton. And actually, that's what I'm working on right now. A couple of my friends and I are discussing forming a biotech company at the moment. And, you know, it's something that I do want to solidify in the future. I want to be able to start my own business that has, you know, can also have an impact on the community as well. It, almost like a social entrepreneur that, you know, you're working on a project that is innovative and revolutionary. At the same time, it's a project that will help people. You know, that's something that I really hope I can get started and I can pursue in the future. And so hopefully the education I get next year, at, next four, couple of years at college, and using that to form this entrepreneurial, the community I'll find that I'm starting this business is something that I want to do in the future. So I guess a social entrepreneur is what I want to be in the future.
Social entrepreneur Soham Daga with us. Of course, that is happening in future, but we see it has already happened to a great extent with all these achievements, Intel Science Talent Search, finalists, members of a member of National Honors Society, International Science and Engineering Fair competition at California, as well as Congressional Award Gold Medal for his volunteer services. Effortlessly, what he shared is truly enriching and inspiring. And we wish him a great future, thanking Manojji and T.R. Dagaji to be with us. And once again, congratulating you, Soham. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
This is Ashok Vyas wishing you a great, great weekend. Do join us on Monday. Namaskar.